Hello, my name is Luis Leon. I'm a program manager on Azure Active Directory, and with me today, my colleague.
Hello, everybody. I'm Jeevan Disarda. I'm a program manager in Azure Active Directory.
Today, we're going to be talking about SaaS applications in Azure AD and how to configure single sign-on. What is Azure AD for SaaS applications? Azure AD provides a secure and simple way to use organizations' accounts to access company resources and different type of applications. After signing in, the user can launch applications from Office 365 or Azure AD My Apps Access Panel. Administrators can centralize user account management in Azure AD and automatically add or remove user access to applications based on group memberships. Also, administrators can control and audit who is getting access to what resource and add an extra layer of security using other Azure AD features, such as conditional access. Why to enable single sign-on? First, it's about increasing productivity. With all of your employees trying to access multiple applications to be productive, enabling self-service is a powerful tool to give access needs and scale. Also, being able to manage a single identity that can be used across on-prem and cloud environments to access applications. You can manage cost by cutting the dependency with on-premises and access management systems. Also, reduce the needs to acquire multiple solutions to satisfy your identity and access management needs. You can manage risk and stop worrying about availability and reliability and transfer that problem to Azure Active Directory. You can discover those unknown applications and bring them under the IT control to make sure you know by who and what data it's being accessed. Secure your access with conditional access, MFA, and real-time identity protection. You can address compliance and governance by monitoring who has access to what, and ensuring compliance to regulatory requirements by enforcing corporate access policies using audit logs.
What is Azure Active Directory App Gallery? So as the organizations are adopting quickly about different third-party SaaS apps, they want to configure and deploy these apps as quickly as possible. This is the same reason why we have created Azure Active Directory App Gallery. App Gallery is like a common place for all the customers where they can find all the apps what they need and they can quickly configure it. All these connectors or the templates which we have published in the App Gallery are certified and tested by Microsoft. Customers can use these particular applications to configure single sign-on and user provisioning. If somebody wants to see which apps are present in the App Gallery, they can also use our Azure Marketplace website where all these applications and their capabilities are publicly listed. There are different types of integrations available in the App Gallery. Very common type of integration which customers use is federated single sign-on. Azure Active Directory does support different type of federation protocols like SAML, WS Federation, and OpenID Connect OAuth. We do also support password vaulting, where the user's password can be vaulted through Azure Active Directory, and we replay that particular username and password in the browser, which gives the feeling of password single sign-on. The link single sign-on is another technique where user can easily configure and use the quick websites which they want to navigate to. The most important and the great feature what we have in Azure Active Directory is about user provisioning. You can automate the user provisioning of identities from Azure Active Directory to these third-party SaaS applications. The common protocol what we use over here is KIM or some of these particular custom connectors which Microsoft has written. Now we will see the demo of Azure Active Directory App Gallery. Here I'm logged in into Azure Active Directory as a global admin, and in the enterprise application is the page through which you can manage all your third-party SaaS applications. By clicking on the new application, you can explore our App Gallery. You can see there are 3,000 plus applications available in the gallery, and I can search any application what I want. I'm trying to search for a Salesforce application over here. And in the Salesforce application, when I click on it, I can see what are the different types of single sign-on modes supported by this application. Here, the Salesforce application support password-based single sign-on and SAML-based single sign-on. Administrator can also look around the documentation of these apps, how to configure and deploy them by clicking on this link. There is also a non-gallery application template available if the customer want to configure any of the generic app or the line of business application which uses SAML or AWS Federation as a protocol. This particular template also does support the automatic user provisioning using SCIM along with password single sign-on. Now, if the application is not available in the gallery, then we will see how customers and these vendors can able to request an application to be added into the app gallery. This workflow is available for all our customers and even for the independent service vendors so that they can request an application to be added in the app gallery. We use Microsoft Application Network Portal for this reason. The first workflow which we are going to see is for our customers. Customers can log in into the Microsoft Application Network Portal and submit a request for the app to be added into the gallery. Based on that request, Microsoft team will reach out to that vendor and will start a conversation and provide a value why this application has to be added into the app gallery. Once the ISV submits that particular integration details in the portal, then Microsoft team and that vendor team configure and test this integration. And after the integration test, the Microsoft will publish the documentation and make that app available in the gallery. So this is the Microsoft Application Network Portal. This is how it looks like. There is a separate tile over here where a customer can request an app and they can submit a request. They can also like and subscribe to the feeds where other customers have already requested an app. If they submit their own request, they can track their own request into this portal through the track request page. Now we'll see for how the ISVs or the service vendors can able to request an app into the gallery. ISV can directly submit a request in the portal along with their integration details. Microsoft will configure that app and provide a way so that these vendors can themselves test this integration on our platform. Once this integration test is successful, Microsoft and that particular ISV vendor jointly creates a document and publish it into the docs website. Once this document is published, then Microsoft will publish this app into the gallery, and from that point onwards, this app is available for all our mutual customers. Again, in the Microsoft Application Network Portal, we have a submit request as a button where they can choose the capability where they want to enable this app for federated single sign-on or for user provisioning. After that, they can select different type of federation protocol, what they support, and provide all the details so that Microsoft team can view this request and perform the integration test as needed. Thanks for watching this video. And in the next video, Luis will talk about how to configure and troubleshoot the single sign-on.